You're watching News to Go on 4029. Meteorologist Chris Swain. We were off to a very warm start throughout the day today. Temperatures are going to be pushing the upper 50s, even low 60s. Let me show you what I'm talking about here in our hour by hour model. Temperatures already warming up by 11 a.m. Upper 40s expected. We'll hit the 50 degree mark and fly past it in places like Waldron, Mena, and Fort Smith at 56, even Fayetteville in the low 50s. Very warm for early January. We're going to continue to warm throughout the day. Friday by 4 p.m. some showers starting to develop, a lot of cloud cover expected throughout the day. Into the evening hours, things really start to change. This is Friday at 10 p.m. Rain's going to continue to make its way through the area. Into the overnight hours, temperatures will drop very quickly as the system continues to make its way through. By the time it gets to Saturday at 3 p.m., temperatures even cold enough to see some snow start to develop. That's the blue you see there, mainly in northwest Arkansas. We're looking at Eureka Springs, Rogers, into Grove, Benton County, into Delaware and to McDonald County. That'll continue to push out the morning hours on Saturday. Now, some of these snow totals could be pushing 2 inches in some locations, mainly north into the River Valley. A few snowflakes possible, but not a whole lot of accumulation there. Mainly north of Highway 412 would be the area to see some of the highest totals, 1.6 inches in Siloam Springs as well as Rogers. As that continues to accumulate throughout the day on Saturday, don't be surprised to wake up to some snowflakes tomorrow morning. Josh.
All right, thanks, Chris. Well, a man is facing multiple felony charges now, and what police say is one of the biggest local pot busts that they've ever seen. Officers say that they seized over 300 pounds worth of marijuana from 69-year-old Vincent Marquez. Officers said that the street value of all of that totals close to $1 million. In addition to that, police say that he had drug paraphernalia, $81,000 in cash, and several guns. Well, the University of Arkansas is banning hoverboards. They're one of at least 20 universities in the U.S. to make that decision. Nationwide, campus officials say that the two-wheeled machines are just unsafe. Beyond the risk of falls and collisions, colleges are citing warnings from federal authorities about the gadgets catching fire. Some other universities on that list include Louisiana State, University of Iowa, and Florida State University. A local nonprofit aimed at helping victims of child abuse is breaking ground on a brand new part of their operation this morning. 4029's Brad Carl shows us how the group says that the new additions will help keep kids safe in our community.
We're here at the Children's Advocacy Center of Benton County in Little Flock early for this morning, and a little bit later on, the team here will be breaking ground on a whole new addition to their facility to meet the growing need for child abuse resources in the area. Now, the Children's Advocacy Center has worked to provide counseling and support for victims of child abuse since it was founded back in the year 2000. With a record-breaking 700-plus children brought in for help and 2,500 counseling sessions throughout the year, the center says they simply need more space to accommodate the growing numbers. This new addition will be one of the largest expansions the center has seen in the past 16 years. Now, the groundbreaking ceremony will start here at 10 o'clock this morning, and the public is invited to come out and attend. In Little Flock, Brad Carl, 4029 News.
There you go. The new edition is expected to be finished by the end of this year. That's your News to Go. Have a great Friday, everyone. I'm Joshua Cole.